Hi, Bill Landing, once again on Interesting Individuals. My guest right now is the first ever LaPorte County Fair Queen, and she's going to share a little bit about that title, some of the things that she is doing with it, future plans, and why she is an interesting individual. Joining me is Melissa Smoker. Melissa, I'm glad you could join me today, and you've been hearing this a lot, but anyway, congratulations again on being the Miss LaPorte County Fair Queen, the first one ever in 2014. Let's talk a little bit about your interest in wanting to be in the Fair Queen contest.
Well, I've been going to the Indiana State Fair since I was about 5 years old, and I've been at the LaPorte County Fair all my life. And when I found out that Miss Indiana State Fair, in order to be in that pageant, you had to win your county fair pageant. Well, we didn't have one. So I thought about going to other county fairs, maybe participating in their pageants. But then when I found out that our county was having one, I mean, I couldn't resist not joining that. So I decided to compete for Miss LaPorte County so I could compete to be Miss Indiana State Fair.
Okay, let's talk about the steps that had to be done, like, you know, filling out an application or being interviewed ahead of time, what they were looking for.
In the application, we had to write an essay explaining what we thought traits that a queen should have. And besides the essay, we also had to write down what service we've done in the community, and they just really wanted to see what kind of involvement you had in the community.
Mm-hmm. So, all right, so then we're going to lead into now you do have some 4-H background.
Yes, I have 10 years of 4-H under my belt.
Okay, well, let's talk a little bit about what went on in those 10 years of 4-H.
Well, I participated in the Dairy Steer Project and also the Beef Project, and I did fairly well in the Dairy Steer Project, and then I also did consumer clothing and sewing, and I also participated at the Indiana State Fair with my dairy steers.
Okay, were these your own steers that you yourself owned?
Yes.
Okay, all right. Now, that's got to be quite a task to take those animals down to Indianapolis. Everything go okay when you did those things?
Yeah, I mean, we'd hit a few road bumps along those 10 years, but overall, it was a good experience.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. Do you remember where you placed with some of the contests with the steers?
I received Grand Champion Dairy Steer at the Indiana State Fair in 2012. And then I also received Reserve Grand Champion Dairy Steer at the State Fair a few times because I would always get second to my brothers.
Oh, wow. Uh-huh. That made them happy, though, didn't it?
Yeah, but not their little sister.
No, sure. Now, you said something about doing sewing.
Yes.
Have you sewn some of your own clothing?
Yes. I did 10 years of sewing, and I also got to go down to the State Fair with my sewing projects as well, where I modeled, and I also did construction for those outfits.
Construction and modeling for the outfits. Okay. All right. So a lot, you know, when you're learning at such a young age, you're getting involved in 4-H projects. It's really your learning discipline, you're learning about involvement and responsibility. So let's look back on what 4-H taught you.
Oh, it definitely taught me that you need to be a responsible person because nobody else is going to go out there and feed your steers for you. You have to be responsible and say, I'm going to go out there and I'm going to feed those steers, or I'm going to go walk those steers and tame them down so that I can show them at the county fair. And it just taught me that you need to be responsible and have respect and grace so that when you don't do as well as you'd like, you need to have grace and be able to say, yes, that person did do better than me. I'll just do better next year.
Sure, yeah, because you've got to take the animals and go to or the fair, and then we were taking them down to the state fair. That's now. Kidding aside, were your brothers so supportive and helpful? Like when you were getting a little bit older to get in the 4-H, and then they would say, "Well, here's what we had to do and help you out, though."
Yes, they were very supportive of me. They even my last year, none of my brothers were in 4-H with me, so they all kind of pitched in, saying, "This is what you need to do if you want to win, and this is mm-hmm. what you want to do if you want to do well." So they were very supportive throughout my 10 years.
All right, now you do have a little bit of background with cheerleading and gymnastics. Let's hear about that.
Well, I was a cheerleader for 9 years, and I was a gymnast for about 5. I did gymnastics when I was about 4 years old to about 9 years old when I decided that I wanted to get more into cheerleading.
Mm-hmm.
So once I quit gymnastics and started cheerleading, just kind of took off there. But mm-hmm. In 2011, I tried out to be in the All-American Cheerleaders squad, and I ended up making it, which that... made me go into the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade in 2011. So I was the only representative of Indiana there at the Thanksgiving Parade.
Wow, and let's talk a little bit about what that was like. That had to be quite an experience, the Big Apple.
Yeah, it was a lot for a little farm girl to be going to the big city. It was a great experience, though. I was there for a week, and I ended up getting sick there at New York, too. I ended up getting... a fever and strep throat.
Oh,
but,
my gosh.
Yeah.
The whole time you were there?
For the last 4 days, yeah.
Did it affect you being in the parade?
I decided that I was going to be in the parade anyways, but I had a fever while I was performing there at the parade.
Oh, now, do you remember how long the parade was?
I believe it was 7 miles long. And we had to walk all of that and do cheers
heavens.
The whole way through. And then we had a performance at the very end in Herald Square and... It was a great experience.
I bet it was, yeah. Now, do you remember approximately how many different girls were there with you?
There were 250 other cheerleaders with me.
Wow, then they had to break that down into groups to rehearse. How much practice time did you have, like, leading up to the parade? I mean, even the days before.
We had practice 2 hours every day in the evening time. And then the rest of the day, we had time to just go explore New York City.
Cheerleading is a more difficult activity than people think. You just don't go out there and cheer. I mean, camps to go to and practices, it's more demanding than people think.
Oh, yeah. I've had broken bones because of cheerleading.
Oh, no. What have you had break?
My ankle. I had to get surgery on it and everything to fix it all up.
All right. Now, your gymnastics activities, was that in high school?
No, it was more elementary school.
Oh, okay. She didn't do that when you were like a
teenager.
Yeah,
but I am a gymnastics and cheerleading coach at a local gymnastics gym.
So. Oh, which gym is that?
Horizon Gymnastics in Valpo.
Oh, okay. What do you specialize in? Is there a certain type of meet that you specialize with teaching the girls?
No, I teach more of the little kids, more of like the 18 months to about 9 years old. So
mm-hmm.
I teach more of the early stuff.
Well, let's hear about this year's Indiana State Fair.
Okay.
Just got back last weekend.
Yep. I went down last weekend, and I volunteered to be helping there at the State Fair with the younger kids, and I got to teach them about agriculture, which is a strong suit of mine, so luckily I knew what I was talking about there. But, yeah, I just got to meet a lot of young kids throughout the state and teach them about ag.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good enough. All righty. So, but this isn't your first trip down that you've been doing. Okay. All righty. Good enough. Now, you're involved with music.
Yes.
You play the mandolin, piano, and the guitar. Tell me, please, how is each instrument unique in its own way when you're playing them?
Well, with the piano, you, of course, have all the keys. But I started out on piano. I didn't learn guitar or mandolin first. I learned the piano first. Because with that, you learn how to read music and you learn the different notes. In mandolin, you have 6 strings instead of just the 5 that the guitar has, or the 6 that the guitar has, but the 6 strings are the same notes, the 2 strings, 2 strings, 2 strings, they're all the same.
Mm-hmm.
And so you have to learn how to pick on that, but the guitar is much simpler than the mandolin, definitely, because you only have 6 strings, but they're all different notes, and they're spaced out more. With mandolin, you need to get your fingers closer together, and you just need to have a smaller hand to do the mandolin. Versus the guitar, you need more of a bigger hand, and I kind of lack in the hand size, but I'm a girl, right? So but the piano definitely did teach me all the basics for all the instruments.
Alrighty. So, and you brought one of your guitars today, so just take a moment there, and we're going to have Melissa put the guitar on the table, and that is a nice one. And why don't we'll just set it up this way, and we take a look at it from the audience, and tell me what type of guitar it is.
It's a Martin guitar, and I got it for my 19th birthday from Mom and Dad. So.
Good. Now, how many guitars do you own altogether?
I only own two, but the first one I had was my mom's old guitar, and that was one that she had through college, and her first house burned down. She ran to her burning house to go save that guitar. So
we're sorry to hear about that in general. Well, yeah. And then, so then let's just go ahead and just, I don't know if you just want to take just a few strums on it. Just let's just see a little bit of those nimble fingers.
I don't know.
That's fine. Just go ahead a couple more times. That is a nice little rhythm. All right. Do you have any favorite guitar music songs that you like to do?
I love the old-time country, old-time gospel. So I like to play I'll Fly Away by Alison Krauss and Union Station. More of the older feel.
Okay. All righty. Well, good enough. We'll just set that back up on the table. Thank you for bringing that along.
No problem.
And guitars, certain instruments like that, do they need to be pampered, like being kept in a cool place?
Definitely. You can't leave it out in the heat, and you can't leave it out in the freezing cold weather, because otherwise the wood will get damaged and strings will break, and gotta take care of it.
Alrighty. Let's talk a little bit about school, where you're going, and what you're studying.
I go to Purdue University, and I am studying elementary education and theater arts, and I'm a junior, so I'm almost done.
Alright, so you're heading back. Do you pretty much stay down there, do you? You're just there once in a while. You get up on a weekend now and then?
Yeah, I come up for, I guess, when I'm needed for Queen stuff. So.
Alrighty. Well, it's just been a brief time that you've had this title, but what's been the most exciting aspects of it? What have you enjoyed the most?
Oh, the most exciting thing for me is meeting several people from throughout the county and the state. And then also, I also loved during Fair Week when I got to participate in the No Hands Pie Eating Contest. That was a lot of fun.
Oh, bravo. Okay. You didn't wear the sash and the tiara, though, when you did those, did you?
I actually did.
Oh, well, you're having fun, so that's it. So, all righty. So then back to school a little bit, and then you've got a couple more functions this summer. What are you going
to
be doing?
Well, I get to go back down to the state fair and participate in Queen's Day, where all the county fair queens come to the state fair. And I also have the Scarecrow Festival, Hannah Fest, Mill Pond Parade, and Pumpkin Fest that I need to go to. So just a lot of festivals.
Well, you're the first ever in this position, so it's a lot of fun. All right, Melissa Smoker, the first ever Miss LaPorte County Fair Queen, thank you for visiting with me, okay?
Thank you for having me.
Alrighty. I will be right back.
Queen of the LaPorte County Fair 2014, the queen receives a gift basket that somebody has, a bunch of flowers, a tiara thing, and a $500 scholarship, and it goes to Poles. The first ever queen of the LaPorte County Fair 2014 is Melissa Smoker!